Hi, Alan Stratton here from CostMatters.com. In a recent LinkedIn forum, someone posted the question, is forecasting a waste of time? Is it more important to be able to deal with variability than predict it? Now, a question of this type tends to drive strong reactions, but the question is really comparing two different things. People who like apples will make the case for apples being more important, and they will insult orange lovers. Orange lovers, in turn, will promote oranges and describe all the rotten apples they've ever come across. The real question to answer is, does this fruit salad taste good with this mix of apples and oranges? A forecast will never be 100% accurate. No one knows the future. Depending on the nature of the particular business or the forecasted item, the past may be used as a guide to the future, but the past never determines the future. In math terms, the future is an independent variable, and the past may or may not be a correlated variable. The nature of the forecasted item will drive the degree of correlation. In fact, I know one university professor who would probably react in the extreme. To him, if he cannot explain all of the results, he would not try to model any of them. He would then focus on dealing just with the variability. I disagree. I would try to forecast or model as well as is practical. This would accomplish two primary results. First, operations would have at least some basis to plan from, and second, the business could learn how to deal with variability, or how to reduce variability, or how to exploit variability, probably all three. An integral part of the forecast should be its accuracy and an examination of its inherent variability. Where does the variability come from? How much does the forecast explain? Given the futuristic nature of all forecasts, no one should be criticized for inaccuracy in the forecast. Instead, the business should embrace variability and learn how to best deal with it. On the other hand, if someone is deliberately gaming the forecast, they should be soundly, but figuratively, publicly whipped with a sailor's cat of nine tails. Actually, dealing with business variability goes beyond the forecast to be an operations response issue. Is the business good only when variability is low? What happens with variability out at the tails of the variability distribution? Does the business fall apart or does it thrive? To me, a good fruit salad has a balance of apples and oranges, plus some bananas, nuts, and such. Mixed with some whipped cream and some carefully selected spices, the salad can be very tasty. In fact, on special occasions, add some chopped up chocolate bars, my favorite. In my salad, both apples and oranges are more important for their respective contributions to the salad. The challenge for us is to find our best business recipe, then how to best consume the result for profitable operations. Let's understand our forecast variability, then fine-tune our operations recipe and profitably exploit the result. I'm sure you've had forecasting experiences. What are they? Please share below this post at CostMatters.com. And remember, when cost matters, profits soar. This is Alan Stratton from CostMatters.com. Thank you.